You guys, car buyers have actually lost their minds. If you know what I'm talking about, hit the thumbs up button. Have car shoppers actually lost it? In a recent article published by Car and Driver citing Cox Automotive, people are willing to pay 12% over MSRP. For the last few years on this YouTube channel, I've been pounding in people's minds, try to negotiate between like 8 to 10% off of MSRP before incentives so that at the very least you can account for the depreciation that's taken place. But no, what the dealers are trying to do because of the supply chain issues is trying to gouge you for an extra 12% because cars are in short supply. These cars aren't appreciating, you guys. So as far as is it a good idea to get a car right now and pay an extra 12%, that 12% that you're paying in addition to the MSRP is because you're either desperate or you really, really need the brand new Chevy Corvette, which did not make its way onto this list because there are plenty of dealers if you just do a quick search. That will sell you this Corvette at MSRP. That's not the problem. The problem is that GM isn't even producing them as quickly as the orders are coming in. So there's multiple different problems, but are you willing to pay to skip the line is the question. Let me know in the comments below what is happening, guys. Ari here from Boston Automotive Consulting, and there's a link to negotiationguides.com, my brand new blog that discusses what to target off of a brand new car. Visit negotiationguides.com by clicking the link in the description below. You'll also be able to connect with dealers simply by picking your car, plugging in your zip, and checking off your local dealers. And if you're new here, please consider subscribing because this whole channel is going to teach you everything you're going to need to know so that you can negotiate your best possible deal. This video is part rant, like the very beginning of this video, part statistics taken from Cox Automotive study, as well as the list of 10 different cars that people are paying 12% or more than MSRP for on average. Diving in, you guys. So the Kelley Blue Book research realizes that 87% of the shoppers actually know that there's a problem out there with the semiconductor shortage, and 73% of the consumers are expecting to face higher prices at the dealerships, and nearly 60 know that they're not going to find much in incentives. 4 out of 10 are willing to pay above MSRP, and those that are willing to pay over MSRP are willing to pay 12% over MSRP to get the car they want. Let's do some quick math. So say we got like a $50,000 Kia Telluride and we really, really want it. And we've been hearing some things on the internet about people paying over MSRP. You might be wondering, yeah, that sounds pretty accurate. I've been hearing that on the Kia Telluride and I've been seeing dealer listings above the actual price of the car, and I'm confused as to why. You're wondering why. I think you may have guessed already. $6,000 is about 12% of the MSRP. Some dealers are tacking this onto the MSRP, and some buyers are just making offers over MSRP in order to cut in line. This is commonly the case with some cars like the Mercedes G63. So given all this, according to Cox Automotive, the research shows that 37% of in-market consumers are now planning to postpone their purchase. Of those consumers deciding to delay, 70% will step back for 3 months or more, and I don't blame them. So what are these hot cars, you might ask? Well, let's run through the list and I will tell you guys. Now, this list is by no means the complete list of cars people are willing to pay over MSRP for. However, they are the most popular cars people are willing to pay over MSRP for. We've got the Acura MDX, we've got the BMW M3 and M4, we got the Chevy Tahoe, we got the Cadillac Escalade, the Honda Civic Type R, the Jeep Wrangler, the new one, the 4XE, the Kia Telluride, and the Hyundai Palisade, no surprise there, the Mercedes AMG G63, the Genesis GV80, the Porsche 911, and the Porsche Taycan. Let me know which one of these cars is your favorite. Let me know in the comments below if you'd be willing to pay 12% over MSRP for one of these things or what you would be paying for over MSRP, under MSRP, whatever it is that you got in mind, what you'd actually be willing to pay. You guys, link to negotiationguides.com in the link in the description below where you can log on, check out some of these negotiation guides on brand new cars. It updates frequently, it updates daily. The moment I upload a video is when negotiationguides.com gets updated as well. And if you found this information useful, please consider subscribing. Thank you so much for watching, guys. We'll see you next time.